Hi everybody, I'm Kirsty Meakin from Nao Nails. In this video, I'm going to show you how to do a black to nude ombre in acrylic. Some people really struggle with this, so I'm going to show you how. Right, dehydration of the nail plate. I'm going to prime. Two coats of primer. Then with a sculpting form, I pop the tab on the back. I'm going to roll it between my fingers. Not fingers. They're definitely not fingers, are they? They're
imagine
definitely.
Your
oh, imagine if they all look like that. Wow. I'd need like stick two sculpting forms together just to get it on. Yeah, rolling it between my thumbs. Right, what I'm going to do is get a little bit of clear. I washed my hair yesterday and it feels pinking already. Sorry. I'm going to put a thin layer of clear down. Make sure it's thin. If it's not thin, it will not win. Right, so I've got Cameo and I've got Pure Black. Now, which colour do you think I'm going to use first? Black. Which colour do you think I'm going to use first, Adam?
I think I'm going to use Cameo.
And you said?
I thought black.
JJ is the winner.
Oh, I was just saying that because I knew it was.
No! But... You were just saying it, weren't you? Yeah, oh, just let Jay win.
I know that you've got to use the dark colours first.
Whatever, Adam.
Whatever. If we were doing it in white, we would use the white first because the white is the brightest, more intense colour. And it's the same for the black. The black is the more intense colour. We're going to use that first and then we're going to blend the nude over the black. So we have Pure Black. If you were putting the black at the tip, you would obviously work from the tip up to the cuticle. I'm actually putting the black at the top at the minute. We're coming down, 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 press, 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 blend, press and blend. Press, 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 press. Going to add a tiny bit more at the back. Going to get a bit of a wet bead and just blend that there just to get it flowing and blending before I've even put on the Cameo colour. So that's what you need. You don't want no harsh lines underneath because it's a strong colour. It will leave harsh lines if you don't blend. You need to blend, 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 just like you do with your contour. Oh. Now we're going to use Cameo. I'm going to bleed this out because I'm going to start here. And I want it to be quite a strong pigment. I'm going to add firm pressure and start to blend. Sorting this free edge shape out while I've got it at that setting point where it really stays still and it stays where I put it. And now we're going to get a bead, and we're not going to bleed this one out. We're going to go straight on top, whip it over, and then we're going to blend. Blend, 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 blend. Softly, softly does it. Keeping the sides nice and straight. wet bead again. Blend it up. So you're going from a dry bead towards the end. It's a lot drier towards that tip. And then you're going to blend with the wet beads. Crazy. What we're going to do now is use True Pink to create the rest of the structure. True Pink is a transparent pink. So when we add that on top, it actually helps the blend because it gives it a really subtle blend. So it kind of masks the blend a little bit. It just makes it more sheer. It's a sheer colour. Mm. You know what I mean? So it does help the blend. I mean, you can put clear over it, but I do think True Pink does give it that extra helping hand to blend it. I'm going to pinch this now. I'm going to take the foam off.
I love that feeling.
That release.
It's when you move the sticker off the skin.
Right, I'm going to file this nail. I'm going to do my normal filing routine, going to the side walls first, make sure they're nice and straight. Then I'm going to do the cuticle area, and then I'll contour the top. Now I'm going to buff, just to smooth that nail out. So you can see the reason that I put on the True Pink is so I don't hit the cameo or the black, so you know you're not going to disturb the blend. A lot of people do an ombre and actually don't cap it with anything, so what they do is they hit the two colours that they merge together and then it just all goes a bit like a bit messy. So this is the key to your problem. Everyone needs a bit of True Pink in their life. It does work the same. True Pink will work the same for when you do a French ombre as well, whether it was white. You know, if it was white, it still works the same. It gives you a lovely, lovely blend.
So would clear not do that?
No, it just doesn't do it the same.
It's got that little bit of...
Just that little bit of pink. Yeah, that little bit of sheer pink just makes it like, oh, beautiful. Just blends it beautifully. So you can see you've got that beautiful blend. But guess what? We can't just leave it like that, can we? Because that would just be a bit cack, wouldn't it?
A bit cack.
So what we're going to do is we're going to put just a little bit of something on it. So what I've got is a little bit of black polycolour. I'm mixing it with a little bit of water because it is really pigmented. And because I want it to flow like nicely on the nail. And what we're going to do, we're going to pull it from there and we're just going to create some little squiggly bits. I don't know if these have a name. Should we give them a name? What about, should we call them Bob?
Bob and Peter.
Yeah, Bob and Peter.
Wisps.
Wisps. Willow the Wisp. So we're just going to do a few Willow the Wisps. And I love the randomness of the old Willow the Wisps. I'm going to seal this with Mega Gloss. Make it nice and shiny. Oh, I do like this myself. I think I need it in my life.
I'll do it for you.
Will you, Jay?
I just know I'll do it.
You know I'll do it now, don't you?
It's in a tutorial.
Oh, yeah.
Mm-hmm.
See how? Check you out. Pop that in the lamp. I I'm going to finish with some lemon cuticle oil. So there you are, that's a perfect blend from black to nude with a little bit of extra art. I hope you've enjoyed the video. Don't forget to check us out on Facebook and Instagram. All the products I've used today will be down below in the description box. And I'll see you guys in the next video. Bye bye! Oh, it's a bit like...
Does it look like tree twigs?
Yeah, tree twigs on like a ghostly night.
Tree twigs?
Definitely tree twigs, not, you know, the normal ones.